Hi there guys, and welcome to Guitar Interactive. My name's Tom Quayle, and today I have a review of this rather fabulous Orange TH100 100 watt head. Very classy looking amplifier, English, British made. And this thing basically has four 12AX7s in the preamp, or ECC83s if you call them that way, and four EL34s in the power stage, and also has a tube buffered effects loop, which has a 12AT7 or ECC81. In that section, and we have a delay pedal plugged into the effects loop so you can hear that working as well. It's got a pretty cool power stage in that you can actually use it if 100 watts is too loud, which it probably will be for most people. You can use it in full power or half power. Now that basically obviously drops the power stage down to half power, so if you're running 100 watts it's dropping it down to 50, but you can go further than that because you can actually switch out two of the power amp tubes as well. So two of those EL34s will become redundant, and that drops the power down to, when you're in half power mode with just the two power tubes, you get 35 watts. If you notch up to full power, you get 70 watts. So you've got quite a few power options here. And that's great because when you're running in your studio or in your bedroom, you don't want to turn up too loud if you're at home. You can actually crank up the power stage using the volume control, and you'll get that beautiful kind of power tube saturation that we all want from our tube heads, basically, but at a more moderate kind of volume. And it's just a flick of a switch. It's dead easy. It's going to knock out two of those power tubes. The amp sounds superb. So in a minute, I'll let you hear it. But let me just run through the front panel for you so you can see what's going on control-wise, and then we'll try out a few settings, see what it sounds like, basically. So running from, in this case, my left to right, we start off with the on and off control, obviously. The standby is slightly more involved than the average amp, in that you up when you're in the middle, you're in standby mode. As you flick up, you've got full power. So with the two tubes, engaged, you've got 70 watt mode. With the half power engaged down the bottom, you've got 35 watts. So you can have either or. Moving over, you've got dirty or clean. So you obviously switch down for the clean channel, up for the dirty channel, and that's foot switchable as well. We haven't actually got the foot switch set up, but you can do that if you wish. Fetching orange LED, which is kind of cool. I love the little symbols that Orange use on their amps. They're very unique. And the controls here are pretty much self-explanatory, basically. For the dirty channel, you've got volume. So you can, there's no actual master volume on this amp, so you use the volume as you would expect. You can get more sort of power amp distortion or saturation if you desire. We've got shape control, which is basically an all-in-one EQ control. When you have it over to the left, it's more of a kind of classic rock kind of sound. And as you move further over to the right, you get more scooped kind of mid-scooped out kind of metal kind of sound, which you'll hear later on. Gain, unbelievable amount of gain on this from those four 12AX7s. So there's way more than you would ever need, basically. So you can really, really dial in tons of saturation. Moving over to the clean channel, we've got treble control, bass, and again, volume. And it's really, really loud, this amp. We're running it through a 4x12, an Orange 4x12 in our ISO booth. And it's mic'd up with a couple of different amps, a condenser and a dynamic mic. So you really get the best of both worlds. And obviously your input. Okay, so that's the controls. Very, very sturdy, well-built amplifier. Around the back, you've got a couple of 8 ohm, sorry, outputs and a 16 ohm output for running a 4x12. You've got your effects loop. And the foot switch output. So that's basically what you've got on the amp. Let's have a listen to it. So at the moment, we're in full power mode, but with all four tubes engaged. So we're in full power 100 watt mode, and we'll switch down to half so you can hear some of the tube saturation in a minute. I've got the volume on the clean channel, about halfway up. So it's nice and clean. It's not breaking up too much. Bass is rolled down because the volume's quite high, so I've brought the bass out because there's a lot of natural bass occurring. And the treble is about 3/4 of the way up. On my neck pickup of my guitar, and we get this sound. And that just, I love it. It's really, really, really fun to play with. I've been playing with this for about half an hour now, and I cannot stop playing. It just is a superb clean sound. Now, with that volume about halfway up, what you're getting, as you can hear, is a really clean sound, but just enough kind of bite that when you dig in, you're getting that snappy, punchy sound. that the tubes are providing. Really, really nicely compressed top end on that one. But you've got tons of dynamic control, and it's a really, really pleasing and addictive clean tone. Now, as we roll up, basically, if we roll the volume up, and again, remember, we're in 100 watt mode here, so we've got tons and tons of clean headroom. What you'll hear now is more breakup occurring. I mean, that is just fantastic. That's exactly what you want from a tube amp. And you've rolled the volume almost all the way up. You can hear the harmonics coming through, the crunch that you're getting. But the great thing about this amp is that compression is allowing you to play with pretty much a clean sound, but there's no effort involved in the playing at all. If you play a little bit quicker, those notes just pop out basically. It feels superb to play with. And then if you back the volume back down again, roll the tone control off a little bit. Got a beautiful jazz tone basically. It's a really, really versatile amp on that clean channel. So let me just really quickly let you hear the sweep of the EQ controls. You're going to get way more bass than you need when the gain is, well, the volume in this case is this high up, but I'll let you hear it anyway. So I'm going to sweep the treble control, let you hear what's going on. I'll just play a couple of strings so you can hear that. So even when that treble control was rolled right back down, you're getting a really beautiful tone. Really, really nice, very impressive clean channel on this amp. Okay, so that's the clean sound. And obviously if you switch down to half power, it's gonna break up even more. Let's have a very quick listen to that. Okay, so again, the volume's rolled up. We're in 70 watt mode here with four tubes. So we'll get a little bit more breakup, but obviously if you drop down to a two tube mode, you get even more breakup from that power section. Great crunch sound for rhythm stuff. We take that delay out. Roll the treble back up. Cool sound, absolutely fantastic. Okay, and you get even more drive by dropping the power stage down to two tubes. So let's switch over to the dirty channel and have a listen to that. And what we'll do is I'm gonna roll the gain down here because it's quite high already. Roll the volume down just in case we kill ourselves in terms of volume. Switch back up to full power mode. Simple as that, just a couple of switches up. Okay, and then switch up to dirty. Okay, so let's have a listen to, okay, let's crank it up a little bit. So with the gain rolled almost all the way out, you're getting, again, like an alternative clean sound. Just going to bring the shape up to the central position. So you can get a very satisfying clean tone out of the dirty section. If we roll the gain up, okay, this is just under halfway. Cool rhythm sound. Let me just really quickly at this stage show you the shape control, and then we'll apply it to a bit more of a higher gain kind of sound. So you'll hear a real extreme in the mids, especially you'll hear a real extreme kind of change here with the shape control. Let's start with it all the way over to the left. So quite a nasally mid-rangey sound. I'm a big fan of that kind of a sound, actually, really, really cool. Very, very nice sound. Okay, let's keep sweeping across. Now, as you get to the middle, you'll hear the mids of the EQ section just opening up a little bit. You're getting more of a more of a scooped kind of mid-range going on. Okay, and then as we scoop all the way over to the right, now we've got that classic kind of V-shaped EQ curve where the mids have been dropped right out of the signal. Now, if we increase the gain, we've already got a fair amount for rhythm sounds. If I keep going, okay, I've added about another quarter here. Okay, just drop the volume down a little bit because we're gonna get a little bit too loud. And then if I increase the gain all the way, that's not actually a great deal of noise for a 100 watt head running on full power with the gain all the way up. That's really quite quiet. Now, I'm not sure why you'd ever need that much gain, but if you've got like a some really high output humbuckers for that real detuned kind of sound, that's going to be absolutely superb. So a huge range of gain on this amplifier. So again, run the output in half mode with two tubes, you'll get even more gain as you kind of push the power section. So that's the TH100. Fantastic sounding amplifier for both cleans. If you're just after a kind of boutique-y sounding clean tone, it's going to get you that. You've got a nice range of tones with the treble and bass controls only, using that volume control to control the amount of breakup. With the dirty channel, more gain than you could ever need, but a good range either side of that, which is really, really useful. Shape control, really easy. I really like the fact that you don't have to dial in with, you know, treble, bass, mids, presence, all those kind of crazy switches that you find on some boutique amps. You just got one control. It does what you want it to do, basically. Really, really cool. Or if you need more control, maybe, you know, that's maybe not enough for you, but it's something to consider. Power options, superb. Lots of control there in terms of how much overdrive you want or saturation from the power stage, how loud you want it to go. So very versatile in that respect. If you need the power, 100 watts, you're not going to need any more than that. So it is there if you should need it. So superb with the effects loop as well. Go and check one out as soon as you can. I'm sure you'll fall in love with it. This is the Orange TH100. See you next time.
Hello and welcome to iGuitar Issue 8. Michael Schenker is currently on his Temple of Rock World Tour and has taken time out to speak with iGuitar about his career as one of metal's most influential players. Jamie Humphreys interviews Michael and also presents an exclusive Schenker style analysis. All that, plus a look at the history of Dean's Schenker series Flying V. Also recently on tour were Chickenfoot, a supergroup formed by Joe Satriani, Michael Anthony, Chad Smith, and Sammy Hagar. We met Joe and Michael to talk about possibly the finest guitar and bass duo in the business and possibly the world's finest supergroup. How about a masterclass in country picking? Brent Mason is Nashville's number one session guitarist with an unmatched string of credits and a blistering style. Stuart Bull meets Brent to find out how it's done. We also have our usual lineup of hot product reviews, including a boutique Three Monkeys amp, Wampler pedals, a PRS guitar, perhaps Orange's finest tube head yet, and a first review of the TC Electronics John Petrucci Dreamscape pedal. We like that so much, we're giving one away in our free entry competition. Meanwhile, in the quiet room, iGuitar reviews a Larivé 000 and a Crafter electroacoustic. While in the basement, Dan Veal gets to grips with a Dingwall six-string bass, a highly affordable Spectre, a massive Trace Elliott rig, and the much talked about dark glass bass distortion pedal. Add our exclusive tuition columns with downloadable tab, and that's iGuitar, the first interactive magazine for guitarists the world over. Still, completely free.